Hi students, so today I'll be demonstrating on bisecting angle periapical technique. So before we start any technique, make sure you turn on the warning light. So this is the switch for the warning light so that outsiders can know that we are doing some radiographic techniques inside the radiology room. And once you turn on the warning light, you have to focus on the control panel. This is the control panel. And here you can see certain icons, okay? So the C indicates collimator, F is film, D is digital, KV is tube voltage, MA is tube current, okay? So we have to select all these parameters before you proceed the technique. And here in this radiology room, we have short cone radio X-ray tube, so it's auto set, so no need to change the collimator. And coming to the film, we are using digital here. So again, no need to select the film, all right? So make sure you select the digital. So if you're selecting the film, your exposure parameters will change. So it has to be digital format. And then tube voltage and tube current, again, it is auto fixed to 70 kV and 4 milliamperes, all right? So this is the parameters before you select the teeth. And now coming to the selection of the patient. So you have three options here, child patient and middle age or the lean patient and obese patient. So you can actually select the patient size depending upon the patient's age and also the density of the patient. Okay, so we can select the adult patient here. Next, you have to select the teeth number here. So you can see this is for the mandibular anteriors, and that is mandibular incisors. And once you select the tooth, the exposure time will be set automatically. And next is the mandibular premolars and canine and maxillary incisors. So as and when you go here, the exposure time keep increasing. All right. And the next one is mandibular molars and maxillary canine and premolars. Next is maxillary molar and posterior bite wing. So if you look at here, there is anterior bite wing also, and this is for posterior bite wing. So you have to check the tooth number and also the type of technique that you're going to do it. And the last one is for the occlusal. So this one, no need to worry about for today. So you have to focus on the tooth number and also the quadrant. All right. So once you set all the parameters, the exposure time, then only you go further for the selection of the film holder and the film. As a part of infection control measures, make sure you wash your hands first with the soap water. And dry your hands with a paper napkin. Wear the appropriate sized glove. So after you are done with your infection control measures, the next one is to select the right film holder and the film. Okay, so this is what we call easy grip film holder, or it's also called as snap array film holder. And this is meant to do bisecting angle technique. Okay, so the same film holder can be used for the anterior and also for the posterior teeth. In case of paralleling technique, if you all remember, we use aiming ring, right? So because of this aiming ring, it will be quite easier for us to align the X-ray tube head. Whereas in case of bisecting angle technique, this is the snap array holder, which do not have any aiming ring. So it is quite technique sensitive, and you have to remember the point of entry and also the angulation that we'll be discussing later in the video. And next is the selection of the film size. So we have size 0 and size 2. So since we have selected adult patient, I would like to go for size 2. It's written on the plate here, size 2. Okay. And now you have to insert your film inside the envelope. And this is what we call digital sensor. Okay. So this digital sensor, the name of the digital sensor is photostimulable phosphor plate. In short, it is called PSP. Okay. So here you can see the blue surface, and this is the imaging part of the PSP plate. And make sure this blue surface has to go towards the black surface of the envelope. So after you insert the plate inside the envelope, you have to seal the envelope. Okay, so before you insert the film packet into the holder, make sure this is the imaging side of the plate. Okay, so this has to face the x-ray tube. In case of bisecting angle technique, we have to know certain principles that we have to maintain or follow in bisecting angle technique. Okay, so what are those the primary measures that we need to understand here are: the principle of bisecting angle technique is based on the Szynkyi's rule of isometry. Okay, so for that, individual tooth requires certain angulation and also specific point of entry. So let me explain the point of entry and the angulations for each tooth here. So before we know about the point of entry and the angulation, there are two line of concentration for maxilla and for the mandible. For the maxilla, the line of concentration is between the L of the nose and the tragus of the ear. The line drawn horizontally at the L of the nose till the tragus of the line, this is the line of concentration for maxilla. Whereas for mandible, it is 1 centimeter above the base of the mandible. Okay, so this is the line of concentration for mandible. Okay, so this horizontal line is static for both maxilla and this is for mandible, whereas the vertical lines, that differs for each tooth for both the jaws. Okay, so I'll be explaining individually when I'll be talking about individual tooth exposure. And you have to remember that whenever you take projections for maxilla, make sure the patient has to look down. Okay, so the patient head should be down like this so that the occlusal level, that should be parallel to the floor. Suppose if you are taking for mandible, then make sure patient will be looking up so that the mandibular occlusal plane will be parallel to the floor. So these two are standard for any intraoral radiographic technique. In bisecting angle technique, as I mentioned, we have certain angulations for each tooth and where to look for those angulations. So here you can see in the x-ray tube, this is the x-ray tube as you all know. So within the x-ray tube, there are few numbers written there. Okay, so now the x-ray tube is set at 0 degree. Okay, so here you can see 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, right? So the markings above this line is considered positive angulation. The numbers below this line are considered negative angulation. Okay, so if you are moving your tube head downward, so then now the x-ray is coming upward to downward, and this is something called vertical angulation. And if you're directing your x-ray tube head upward like this, now the x-ray is coming downward to upward, so this is negative angulation. So these are the basic measures that we need to understand before proceeding the technique. Okay, so for the posterior bisecting technique, we use the same film holder as we used for anterior bisecting angle technique, but only thing, other end of the film holder will be used for the posterior teeth. So if you see here, there is a broad surface and the narrow surface. Okay, so the position of the film is really important when you place within the film holder, and also the dot. So within the film you have a dot, and make sure the dot is always towards the occlusal surface. Okay, and one more thing I would like to tell, that the angulations in case of posterior teeth, again we follow vertical angulation for maxillary and negative angulation for mandibular teeth, all right? And also the horizontal angulation, please remember, horizontal angulation should be zero for both anterior and posterior teeth. If you're going to tilt your x-ray tube head, that's where you will end up in horizontal overlapping in between the interproximal areas. So try to avoid giving any horizontal angulation. So now let's start taking for maxillary premolar teeth. Okay, this is very important, that is, placing of the imaging plate in the film holder really matters. This is the black surface of the imaging plate, inside is the blue surface, right? So that is the exposing surface that has to be facing towards the x-ray tube. And also in the film holder you have a broader surface and the narrow surface. Broader surface of the film holder must be placing towards the cheek side. Okay, and when you place the imaging plate in the film holder, make sure you just clip at the 2 mm below the imaging plate. Okay, so never clip at 1/4 of the plate or half of the film plate. If this happens, then it will be incomplete coverage of the interested area of concern. So once you clip to the imaging plate, make sure you close the film holder and slightly give a bend so that it will adapt to the anatomical structures there. And I'll be taking for maxillary first and second premolars. Always make sure when you enter into the oral cavity, go horizontal first and make it vertical. Okay, now when you position the imaging plate, though you are taking the premolars, the mesial end of the film, that should be covering the middle half of the canine so that you will cover completely the first premolar. Okay, so don't place the imaging plate exactly at the premolar. Okay, so make sure you position the imaging plate at the middle half of the canine and then slightly close the patient's mouth. Okay, so now you have positioned the imaging plate. Let's move on to the point of entry. So again, we are taking for the maxillary. Make sure patient is looking slightly downward. And then the point of entry for premolars. So the maxillary line of concentration is the same elatragus line, and the vertical line for premolar is pupil of the eye. The center of the pupil of the eye that intersects with the elatragus line. So this is the point of entry for premolars. And coming to the angulation, we give 30 degree vertical angulation, positive 30 degree angulation for maxillary premolar. Now position the X-ray tube head exactly at the point of entry for maxillary right premolars. And you can position the tube head close to the patient's face. And in case of premolar projection, always advise patients to close the eyes so that it will not damage their lens of the eye. So once you position the X-ray tube head and imaging plate, look at the exposure time. So it's written here maxillary premolars. So maxillary premolar 0.40 exposure time. So once you set the exposure time, you can proceed with the exposure of the imaging plate. So now let's move on to the maxillary molars. And always you prefer to take first and second molar in one imaging plate and do not try to cover all three molars in one imaging plate. It will be quite difficult to cover all three molars because the mesiodistal dimension is quite wider compared to your anteriors, right? So before you position the X-ray film in the molar area, make sure the mesial end of the film, it rests at the mid half of the second premolar so that you will be covering the entire first molar. So always go horizontally, and once you enter the area of interest, then make it vertical, and the mesial end of the film should rest at the mid half of the second premolar, and ask the patient to close the mouth. So after you position the film, next is the point of entry. So the point of entry for maxillary right molar, the vertical line dropped at the outer canthus of the eye that intersects with the elatragus line. So this is where the point of entry for maxillary molar. So now let's adjust the X-ray tube head. The angulation for maxillary molar is positive 20 degree. Position the X-ray tube head at the point of entry and make sure your horizontal angulation is zero. So now you can understand what is horizontal angulation, especially for molars. It has to be exactly the central ray of the X-ray beam should be passing through the interdental spaces of maxillary first and second molar. Okay, if you are tilting your X-ray tube head mesial or distal, that will end up in overlapping. Okay, so try to give zero horizontal angulation and you can get better interdental space visible in the image. After you adjust the film placement, X-ray tube. Now this is the exposure parameters. So again, I have set the exposure time for maxillary molar, and if you can see it now, the time is 0.4 seconds for maxillary molar. So now let's look at the maxillary third molar projection. Okay, so we have to place the film as far as possible and do not consider first and second molar. Okay, so focus on the third molar, and after you position the film, make sure the mesial end of the film can be at the second molar and you can cover the third molar. The point of entry for third molar is 1 centimeter behind the outer canthus of the eye. Okay, so the vertical line 1 centimeter posterior to outer canthus of the eye that intersects with the elatrigus line. So that is the distomolar projection point of entry. And the angulation for distomolar projection is same as your first and second molar, that is positive 20 degree. So once you are set for positive 20 degree, adjust the x-ray tube head at the point of entry, and even the exposure time for distomolar projection is same as your maxillary first and second molar, that is 0.42 seconds. Now let's do it for mandibular premolar projection. And coming to the film placement, again the black surface here on the envelope should be facing towards the x-ray tube and the broader surface should be facing towards the cheek side. Okay, and clip the imaging plate at the tip of the imaging plate like this and lock the film holder, slightly give a bend to the imaging plate. And again you can ask the patient to slightly lift up the tongue so that you can place the imaging plate in the floor of the mouth. And the mesial side of the imaging plate, that should rest at the mid half of the canine so that you can cover both first and second premolars. Okay, so position the imaging plate at the mandibular premolars and then ask the patient to close the mouth. And again we should remember that we should ask the patient to look upwards whenever we do the mandibular teeth so that the mandibular occlusal plane will be parallel to the floor. So the point of entry for mandibular premolars is the same as maxillary premolars. The vertical line drop at the center of the pupil that continues until it intersects at the line of concentration for the mandible. Okay, so 1 centimeter above the base of the mandible, this is the point that intersects with the vertical line drop at the center of the pupil of the eye. So this will be the point of entry for mandibular premolars. And the angulation for mandibular premolars is negative 10 degrees. Okay, so adjust your x-ray tube head at the point of entry and make sure the circle of the cone is covering the imaging plate entirely. Don't look at the upper end of the cone. Okay, the center of the cone should be at the point of entry. So after you position the x-ray tube head, x-ray film, and then look at the exposure time. So now we are projecting the mandibular premolars. So the mandibular premolars require 0.32 seconds. Okay, so try to select the exact tooth number and automatically the control panel will expose the desired seconds. After you expose, then you can proceed with the processing. So now let's take for the mandibular first and second molars. The position of the film in the film holder is same as I showed for the mandibular premolars. Okay, now I'll be inserting the film at the mandibular molar. The mesial end of the film is resting at the mid half of the premolar. Ask the patient to close the mouth, and the point of entry is same exactly for the mandibular maxillary molars. The line dropped at the outer canthus of the eye and that intersects with the line of concentration of mandible, that is 1 centimeter above the base of the mandible. So this is the point of entry for mandibular molars. And coming to the angulation, angulation is negative 5. So negative 5 for mandibular first and second molar. So position the x-ray tube head exactly at the point of entry and just check the cone is entirely covering the imaging plate. After you set the x-ray film and the x-ray tube head, check for the exposure parameter. So for the mandibular molar, the projection is you have to select the mandibular molar and it is 0.40 seconds. So now let's take for the third molar. So the third molar is also called as distomolar projection in case of bisecting angle technique. And whenever you are taking radiograph for third molar, don't focus on first and second molar. We are focusing only on the third molar and try to push the imaging plate as far as possible so that you will cover the entire third molar if it is vertically positioned. Suppose if it is horizontally positioned, mesially impacted or horizontally impacted, it's quite difficult to cover the entire tooth. But still, we always prefer to take bisecting angle first, and then if it is not visible in the radiograph, then you can go for panoramic radiograph. So now positioning of the film for third molar, let me show you. Always go horizontal and place as far as possible and try to cover the third molar. Okay, and the mesial end of the film, it can be at the second molar area. Okay, so and then you can close the mouth. And the angulation for third molar is same as your first and second molar, that is negative 5 degrees. But the point of entry for third molar is that 1 centimeter posterior to outer canthus of the eye. Okay, that is why it is called distomolar projection. Okay, so 1 centimeter behind the outer canthus of the eye, the line is intersecting with the line of concentration of mandible. So that is the point of entry for distomolar projection. And now I am adjusting the tube at the distomolar area. So the exposure time is same as we gave for mandibular first and second molar. So there is no change in the exposure time, only the position of the film and the position of the tube head matters for distomolar projection. So after you have said everything, okay, inform the patient not to move the film with their tongue, okay, and within no time you have to come and expose the imaging plate. And there is a button here, press the button and do not release the button unless you hear the sound of a beep. Okay, so after the beep stops, you can release the button. So that's when the exposure is completed. So that completes the bisecting angle technique for mandibular and maxillary posterior teeth projection. Hope you enjoy this video. Thank you.